Geneva Public Library. It's Sunday morning, about 8 o'clock. Back to my favorite day, and I brought my good friend with me, the Dutch Push Pulho, to have it as part of our discussion. The library was built in 1954 by Mr. Dressler. He was a student of Frank Lloyd Wright at Taliesin, so it has that prairie-style architecture. And I designed the gardens here, I believe it was 2009 or 2008, we put the gardens in. They wanted something to represent the style of the building. So the gardens have been evolving for at least 11 to 12 years. And I thought I'd show you where we're at this time of year in the summer. I had done a post earlier on Instagram talking about observational weeding, and some people questioned, Roy, what do you mean by observational weeding? And I'll show you as we walk over here. I just looked through the garden. The plants right now are providing for their own well-being because they've smothered out the earth. And when you cut the foot candles of light below 1,000 foot candles to 500 foot candles of light, it's very difficult for weed seeds to germinate. So when I look through here, I see a sancha, a prickly lettuce. So my observational weeding is, I just pull it out. So whenever I see distractions in the garden, we'll go through. Here's another one. And I've got one more in here. I'll pull that out, reach in for this one, and I'm done. So basically, I've covered this whole area, and I've spent the last moments of conversation with you, which is about 5 to 6 to 20 seconds, and I see another sancha over there, another prickly lettuce. So I just walk through the garden, and when you look at the square footage, you might have about 1,000 square feet here. I can cover this whole area in a weeding in maybe 8 minutes, 10 minutes, just looking for the big ones. Let me show you one more. I don't want to wear myself out, so I'm going to go over here. There it is. All right, I got to take a break. I just got another prickly lettuce out. So you can see when you let the plants contribute to their own well-being and they're put together socially so they can live into each other in a healthy way, it really can cut labor, but it really raises the level of joyful gardening because now you're letting the plants contribute to their own well-being. And the Dutch Push Pulho, we can't really use right now because there's no way to get in here. And there's actually no reason to do any hoeing because you can't get into the garden to use it. But it's extremely important. Mid-April to mid-June. We come out every 2 weeks. We hoe about 1,000 square feet in 75 to 80 minutes. And every 2 weeks we get the weeds when they're this big. I can show you where sunlight keeps hitting soil. That's how we go through. And I'm done. So along this edge, we always have sunlight hitting soil. So we come out again every 2 weeks and we hoe the weed when they're about 1 inch to 3 inches tall. And then we rake them up along the edge because we can't leave them here. They're too visible. And then we look for the observational weeding. We walk through. Basically, that's our visit to the garden. And I'd like to show you a few of the combinations we have in here. Of course, Allium Summer Beauty. We have Salvia Snowhill. We have Geranium Tiny Monster. Monarda, I can't remember the name of the Monarda. I'll put it on the screen. It'll hit me as soon as the show is over, of course. And I have Martagon Lilies in here. Anemone Robustissima, which takes up quite a bit of space. But we manage, we take out some of the plants, we trim it a little bit in the spring. And then we have Millennia Paul Peterson and more Geranium Tiny Monster. And then we have Phlox Gina. We put Phlox Gina, it's a tall phlox in the back. And we have just the repetition of those patterns through the garden. And as we get on the other side, we change the repetition of the patterns and introduce some other plants. We have more Stachys Umlo. We have some Nepeta Junior Walker that we have mixed with the Stachys Umlo. So we keep changing the patterns, but yet carry the repetition of what we planted here. This is one I'll show you quickly. This is Sanguisorba Tina. It's just starting to bloom with these small red little finger-like flowers. It actually does very well in average to moist soil. And we have that space through the garden where it just leans here and leans there. So what you become playful with your creations. As long as the plants can share and capture sunlight and have a healthy life. And then we do some thinning. Some of the plants, like the geranium tiny monster, might get too large. So we just thin it a little bit so we don't inhibit its neighbors. And I love that because you and I know what that's called. It's called gardening. We're actually doing some gardening here. And I love the fact that we can differentiate ourselves between the landscapers who come out and keep everything neat and tidy. They're very good at keeping everything neat and tidy, but they sometimes have some difficulty doing anything within the garden because they don't really have a culture of care for this particular style of planting. So if you have any comments, just let me know on the comment line, and I'm happy to visit with you, and thanks for coming out to the library this morning.